Hello everyone. So this session, the topic would be master data. Master data can be defined as a set of data which remains constant for a long time in the database. And this is also the set of data which is repeatedly used without changing the element data. So whenever any transactions are carried out, the set of permanent data which is repeatedly used over and over without basically changing the data is what we call as master data. In the SAP system, again, every component will have its own set of master data. In the MM component, we have four types of master data. We have material master, vendor master, purchasing info record, and source determination. So let's talk about each of these elements individually. The first one would be material master. Material, we're talking about the resource material. So material resource can be defined as a set of elements which are normally purchased externally and which are both quantifiable and non-quantifiable elements. And those elements are what are required to carry out the business activities of the company for, right? So quantifiables are those elements which are measured in terms of a quantity. So here we're talking about all the solid items, liquids, gas elements, whereas non-quantifiables are usually the services, because services are not measured in terms of a quantity, right? Now the material master is the record of all the information which is required to use a material in the SAP system. So whatever be the nature of its requirement or the way you're going to use it, whatever material or services are required to be used, you need to have a material master created, right? Now all this information maintained in the material master record is logically grouped into divisions called views. For example, you have basic data view, purchasing views, sales views, production views, accounting views, storage views, and other such views. Now each material master record will have at least one view. The data in each view actually relates to a specific department in the company core. So if I want to use the material in the purchasing department, then I need to select and maintain the information in the purchasing view. Similarly, if I want to use the material in the sales department, then I have to maintain the sales view. Similarly, production, I need to maintain the data in the production view, so on and so forth. So since each view pertains to a specific department, views are also called as user departments. When a user selects the view, looking at the name of the view, they can understand what type of data is included in it. But within the SAP system, internally, each view is identified with a one character code called maintenance status. So each view will have this maintenance status code using which the system will be able to understand what type of data is maintained and based on that, where the material should be allowed to be used, right? So without selecting the specific view, that view's maintenance status code will not be added to the material master. And without that maintenance status code, the system will not allow the material to be used in that particular process or department. Now the data in each view is again divided into sections called subscreens. Each view again will have at least one subscreen. So for example, the basic data view is divided into material description, general data, material authorization, dimensions, and other such subscreens. So each subscreen, again, the subscreen is grouped based on the type of information maintained, right? So again, in each subscreen, each of the subscreen consists of multiple fields. At least one field should be there in a view, in a subscreen. So the data entered or required by the user to use that material is actually entered in the field. And this data which is saved, it is entered in the field, will be automatically saved in a corresponding database field. So your material mass report will look something like this. The top you have material master divided into views, which is divided into subscreens, which consist of fields. And the data maintained in the field is automatically saved into the database field. It goes two ways, because when you enter the data, it goes to the database field, and when you try to check the data, it is retrieved from the database field, right? So this way, all the data which is maintained in the material master for any component will be linked to a specific database field, and without the data getting saved in a database field, you cannot carry out any transactions in the SAP system, right? Since the transactions in the SAP system are dependent on a database, the application is also called as a database dependent application. Okay. Now, in order to create a material master record, the following initial information is required. First, you require the material number, then the industry sector, then material type, then selection of views, and then organizational data or level. Let's look at what each of these things are. The first one is material number. Material number is used to identify the material or service used in the company code. So, like I indicated earlier, every element used in the SAP system should have an identifier. So, the material or the service used in the SAP system is identified by this material number, which is a 1 to 18 character alphanumeric code, which can be assigned either internally or externally. Internal assignment takes place when the SAP system itself automatically creates the or generates the number based on some predefined number range. External assignment takes place when the end users create the number or code to identify the material based on some predefined number or alphabet range. The internal assignment is done by the SAP application itself. External assignment is done by the end users. Okay. And every material should have a number to identify it, and the maximum number is 18 characters. It cannot exceed the 18 character limit. Next one is industry sector. It is used to identify the industry in which the material is used. Since the application will be normally installed only for one company code, the industry sector will also identify the industry in which the company code operates. As such, it is identified by only a one character alphanumeric code. Material type identifies the usage of the material, how you are going to use the material. So for example, raw material, finished products, semi-finished, trading goods, packaging material, consumables or services. So like this, based on the type of usage, the system will identify and maintain that information. So material type is identified by 1 to 4 character code. Now in the standard system, we have about 50 predefined material types to be used. And these 50 are predefined both in the practice server as well as in the real time. Okay. Since there are already about 50 predefined material types, usually we don't create any new material types. It is not required to create any new material types. Okay, all the existing material types. In fact, for any client, usually we use very less than even the predefined list. Okay. The next one is selection of views. In this, we select the views for which the data will be maintained, based on where the material has to be used, in which department, which process the material will be used. Based on that, the views will be selected. And based on the view selected, the relevant enterprise structure data will be maintained in the organizational data. Okay. So without this initial data, the information about a material cannot be maintained in the SAP system. So let's see how to create a material master record. Material master record can be created in two ways. First one is, as you can see, for immediate activation, creation and activation. That is, as soon as the material information is maintained and saved, I can start using the material. Or the second option is where I create it for a future dated activation. Right? So let's see each one. So for creating the material, we need to connect to the server. So let's connect to the server and start creating the. We need to connect to the server. So let's connect to the server and start creating the material master. So you go to the transaction code, enter the transaction code M101 and the screen here.